Hey guys, Berinfos here, and these are the 10 best cutscenes in GTA Liberty City Stories. Making this list was not actually that difficult because most of the cutscenes in this game are not that great. However, there are about 20 amazing ones and I'll show you some of them. These are my 10 picks for the best cutscenes in the game. The list is opinion based, of course, and if you disagree, let me know what your list looks like. So, without further ado, let's begin with the cutscenes. The final cutscene in Love on the Rocks by Donald. In the past few missions, we did all we could to get Donald on the good side of the people. Donald is completely free now and can run for president, because he has no links to organized crime, or so Tony thinks. After watching the news broadcast on TV, it turns out that yes, we did all the right things. He has no links to organized crime, except that he knows Tony, and since he does, Donald is a criminal too.
Unfit. Because of you. Yeah, and it's all your fault.
The best moment here is how Donald blames Tony for all of this. It's not like I risked my life for him all this time just to help him out, now it's my fault. I totally get his point though. I would be angry at everyone too if I lost $20 million.
And now I'm ruined! Bankrupt! $20 million in the hole!
Now he has to eat out of a can, and unfortunately, there are no cans filled with human meat for sale. Cash in Kazuki's chips for Toshiko. All of Toshiko's cutscenes are slow, and you may consider them boring, because nothing major goes on in them. Well, this one is a bit different. Again, it starts off slow, she's soft-spoken, sad, and somewhat regretful.
Great. Yes, great. Very great.
I killed her husband, and I guess she has nothing to live for. So, she just jumps out the window. No warning, no lead-up, just plop! Out the window.
Truly free. Goodbye, Tony-san.
The saddest part is that I never got my big reward for killing her husband because she's no longer with us. Rough justice for Salvatore. This is the first time we see the big boss in a prison uniform, and I gotta say, that makes me happy. I have never been a big fan of this guy ever since he did what he did in GTA 3 to Cloud. But he's still an interesting character, so I let it slide sometimes. Here though, I'll say that he totally deserved being here. Even in jail, he acts like a big shot. Still complaining, still giving orders, and Tony, being the good boy he is, obeys him.
Of course, Mr. Leone, we're doing everything we can to get you out of here and back to helping your community as soon as possible.
Of course, I hope we can sue someone for this outrage.
He even dressed up as a lawyer for this mission. Yeah, because putting on glasses completely covers his face and he is no longer Tony Cipriani. I like how the conversation goes here. They talk incognito until the guard goes away and then they get down to business.
Alright, get out of here, Lionel.
Bringing the house down for 8 Ball, and no, it's not the opening one. Just like in my GTA 3 top 10 cutscenes video, I added a cutscene with a big explosion. In GTA 3, we blew up a ship. That was massive, right? Well, yeah, it was, but it was nothing compared to what we exploded in this mission. We leveled a whole neighborhood of the city, and yeah, it was very satisfying. So many explosions, so many deaths! Oh yeah, speaking of deaths, just look at these two! Simply fantastic! A car falls down on these guys, the other one, thinking that he is safe, just dies on the spot too! Dead meat for Tony's mom. In the opening cutscene, like always, she tells her son how she is disappointed in him and how she wishes he was never born.
After you took that photo of Kata, he stopped paying his protection money! And what are you doing about it? Nothing!
That's normal stuff. We hear that in every encounter with her. The cutscene on the list, however, is the one in which Kaza gets in the meat factory. The way Kaza speaks makes me happy. He's so nervous because he didn't pay his protection money and he knows how angry mobsters get when that happens. Well, he's very nervous, just listen to his voice.
We can talk about this, right, Tony? Yeah, talking is good.
Tony, being the badass he is, doesn't say a word until the end when he wants Kaza to stay still under a saw. Yeah, that huge saw could cut him in half in 3 seconds. Well, unsurprisingly, Kaza gets scared and runs away. Tony, did you really think that he would just sit there? You're not that scary, mister. A truly great cutscene because of the voice acting, the big saw, and the scream.
Hey, easy with that, Tony. It's the on switch for the...
Contraband by Salvatore. Playing this game, we notice 2 things in Salvatore's persona. He hates his wife and he has a massive respect for Tony. Well, sometimes he has doubts, but deep down, he loves his associate. Both of these things are very visible here. Sal shows massive respect to Tony and no respect to his wife.
Luckily, I can trust someone in my life. You, Tony. You're very important to me. Did I ever tell you that?
Even get it up, you old bastard!
Not for you! I don't like using public toilets, you slut!
Maria, being the loudmouth she is, she tries to act all cool and stuff, calling her husband names. Well, Sal, being the well-spoken boss he is, he counters every one of her words. She got burnt like 4 times in this cutscene. She is now used goods, a public toilet, a slut, a tramp, and so much more. I laughed my butt off when I watched this for the first time. This is the 2nd funniest cutscene in the game, in my opinion. Hot Wheels for Vincenzo. We all hate Vincenzo, right? I mean, does anyone actually like the guy? He has a big ego, he's a nobody but pretending to be a big boss, he screams a lot, but most importantly, something that makes my blood boil, something which shows how big of a scumbag he is him getting a blowjob while talking to his mom on the phone.
Love you. Oh. Hey, Cheryl? Hey, sweetheart? Give it a rest now.
I mean, disrespecting your colleagues and friends is one thing, still terrible but bearable. But doing what you did to your mom, for real, Vincenzo, how low can you get? This cutscene defined his character for me. Before this, I just assumed that he is troubled. He just wants to be a big boss. But no, he's an actual scumbag. The final cutscene in the game, called The Sicilian Gambit. All we worked for in this game came to this. Sal is back in the mansion. I get praises. He gets to boss around the mayor. We met a close acquaintance with him. And I finally got my big reward. Well, it was not exactly what I expected. I mean, Sal promised Tony 2 million, but Tommy got 500,000.
So I got you that 500,000 I promised.
Half? Ooh, I thought you said a couple.
I said $1 million. For what? You can put a price on friendship?
That's an enormous cut, and I would be really mad. But I guess Tony is a bigger man in this situation. This is also the most unsatisfying end to a GTA game, in my opinion. We don't see the biggest enemy at the end, and Tony is not in charge, which can't be said for the other games. However, that's good because it makes this game a bit different than the rest. We fought till the end and the goals were different, but we still reached them. That's satisfying enough. Overdose of Trouble by Maria. In GTA 3, we saw Maria as the helpless young woman being treated horribly by her husband. A woman just wanting to explore her body and searching for a serious relationship. Well, in LCS, it's like she's a whole nother person. She really is. I mean, she sleeps with everyone she meets, she takes drugs, and I don't mean the regular drugs. She gets all of these.
A couple of greens, a couple of heavy reds, all in these grape pills I'm getting from Holland now, pure as hell. I feel great. No, I don't.
Yep, that's the real Maria over there, guys. So even after taking all of that, she wants more. Something called Zap. Tony doesn't even know what that is, and she makes fun of him.
Aw, Tony, you are so square.
The way she says it is pretty funny, and again she calls him square, just like in the previous mission. The cutscene changes the mood so often. It goes from funny, to angry, to scary, to funny, and to angry again. That's why I love it so much. Oh yeah, and of course, because of Audi falling from Maria. And finally, Bon Voyeur by JD. JD is most likely my favorite character in this game, and that's because of this cutscene.
Oh, I'm coming! Oh, but not like that! Hey, Tony, que pasa?
Look at what he's wearing! Even CJ doesn't look that good in a gimp suit, no matter how fat I make him. I mean, look at his buttocks! His cheeks are actually showing and are probably flapping around in the wind. Sadly, the graphics are not that great, so we can see that. This is the funniest cutscene in the game because of how clumsy JD seems. Because of all the humor and because of the money shot. Oh yeah! Tony does not share my opinion, unfortunately, because he doesn't even wanna touch him. And those are the 10 best cutscenes in GTA Liberty City Stories, in my opinion. And I'd like to hear your opinion, guys. Which ones do you like the most? If you enjoyed this video, make sure you leave a like, and if you didn't, then the dislike button is right there too. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next top 10 video!